Hello everyone. There are many confused type of questions where I'll be coming across, or I'll be trying to answer these type of confused questions, mainly some technical based questions, irrespective of branch. And this particular question is mainly related to mechanical and civil engineering. And now there are different questions which comes to our mind, and it is more of a bit little bit confused. So I'll try to answer those type of questions in a much more brief way, where you can understand it in a much proper way. So the question is, what is the difference between pressure and stress, where they do have the same units, pressure and stress, and the units for both of them are same. So first of all, we all know that whether it is pressure or whether it is stress, it is force per force divided by area, and the units for both of them are same, Newton per meter square or pounds per square inch, that sort of thing. Now we know that we should know that the most of us, we do have some kind of doubts, and some kind of concepts are not clear also. So here, in case of pressure is often used with fluids, okay, where the fluids means, you know, it's a substance which can flow easily. It can be a gases or it can be liquids, whereas stress is more often used in case of solids. So pressure is often used in fluids, whether it is liquid or gas, or whereas stress is more often used with solids. Now, one major difference that you will be finding with pressure and stress is, pressure always acts perpendicular to the surface, okay? Pressure acts perpendicular to the surface, and whereas the stress is acting parallel to the surface as well as perpendicular to it. Clear? So I hope you are understanding. And here a stress is parallel to a surface means, I'm talking about shear stress, and wherever the stress that is perpendicular, that type of stress is called as a normal stress. So this is one major difference which we should remember, that is the difference between the pressure and stress. Okay, so the first difference I hope you have understood. Pressure is used with fluids, and where stress is more often used with solids. And one more major difference is, pressure acts perpendicular to the surface, whereas stress acts parallel as well as perpendicular to it, to the surface. And if it is parallel to the surface, that type of stress is called as shear stress. If it is perpendicularly acting, then it's called as normal stress. Now, one more major difference is, pressure can be positive, whereas a normal stress can be negative or positive. Okay, so pressure can only be positive, remember. So pressure can only be positive, it can never be negative. But whereas in case of normal stress, it can be negative or positive. Now, a negative normal stress is called as tension, and a positive normal stress is called as compression. Clear? So see, these are all conceptual questions. Pressure can only be positive, whereas normal stress can be negative and or positive. A negative normal stress is called as tension, and a positive normal stress is called as compression. So let us think about that. Like sometimes the sign convention is somewhat in a different way, with tension being positive and compression being negative. Okay, so as I told you, don't become confused. A negative normal stress is called tension, but when we come to sign convention, it is positive, and a positive normal stress is called compression, but when compared to sign convention, it is negative. For some reason, structural analysis seem to do it in that way, and as you know, they should be the experts, but I always think compression as to be as being positive. Okay, Now, what is the difference between pressure and stress as they have same units? You see, several people, they are saying that pressure is applied to the outside of things and that causes stress on the inside. You understand? That means when we apply pressure on a particular body to the external part, a kind of stress is developed internally. Well, that's not true. Okay, it's nice and simplistic sounding, and we all and most of us jumped into the bandwagon or concluded. And I guess we have concluded by saying that when we apply pressure on the outside and a kind of internal stresses are created, where that this particular concept is a wrong concept. So pressure exists in the interior of fluids just as the same as stresses in solids. That means the particular pressure, it is existing only in the interior of fluid, but just as same as stresses in solids. Now you can have stresses in fluids too, by the way. Okay, it is it's just the shear stress in fluids requires continuous shearing motion, and we know the other word, other name for that is viscosity, whereas solids can sustain the stress continuously without moving. But let me give an example that when we are in a swimming pool, there is a pressure, okay, and you can feel that pressure, or it's some kind of pressure is there in your ear, that is eardrums, when you're diving into a swimming pool, okay. Just because it is a kind of pressure on the outside, it doesn't mean that it's only on the outside. The pressure continues all the way to the inside of your body too. I hope you are understanding. The pressure continues all the way to the inside of your body. Sure, it is sure you could call that as stress too, if you like, but it's still pressure. So you can also have that stress on the exterior of a solid as well as inside. So it's just the force applied to the surface divided by the area that it is applied to. I hope you have understood the basic concept behind the difference between pressure and stress, and as they have the same units. Clear? So I hope you have understood. Thank you. Thank you very much for your patience here.